Hey everyone, Dev with Crime Hive, and in this true crime video, we're talking about two missing children who went missing on December 21st, 2020, and we've later learned that police have even dug up their backyard. So what happened? We're going to talk about the suspicious circumstances in this case. Now, before I do, again, if you like these kind of true crime videos and stories, just be sure to subscribe and share this video with others. They're still missing to this day, and we're looking at January 5th, 2021 now. And the community is concerned, very concerned at this point, and we're going to talk about some of the aspects of this. So just to give you a little bit of context about what this story is all about, if you haven't heard it, you've got two adopted parents here. So both of these children are adopted, and they were adopted by Trizelle and Jacqueline West right here. So you've got them, and I'll play an interview with them as well in this case here. So they adopt them. They've actually got four other children living at the home, two other biological children, and then two other adopted children. So you've got six children in the home, and then of course, you know, Oren and Orson are missing. So what we learned, a couple things, and it takes place here, if you're wondering where this takes place, you've got California City, so it's just north of Los Angeles, just east of Bakersfield area is California City. So that's where this takes place. If you're in that area and you know anything that could be related to this case, please reach out and I'll get you a phone number for that as well. So just refer to my notes here. A couple things that we know. This takes place really on December 21st around 5 p.m. I've heard reports, mixed reports really, somewhere between 5 and 6 p.m. These children go missing, right? Apparently, Trizelle's going out to get firewood in the home, and the mother, Jacqueline's out there wrapping Christmas gifts, okay? So they let their children, Oren and Orson, the adopted children, playing on the back porch there, and apparently they're playing. Trizelle's going out. He sees him. You know, he's going back in. He thought they were there. I've heard reports that the back gate was left open, and you know, he looks back out and they're gone. So apparently they just magically disappear, and you know, both Trizelle and Jacqueline, they start searching all over the house because again, commonly children at that age are found within the home, you know, right around that area within the outskirts of the home. That's where they're typically found when they're missing. Now they search all over. They start searching around the neighborhood, and then it starts to get dark. And so then, according to Trizelle, you know, he needs to contact police at this point because they can't find him, and it's starting to get dark. So police get involved quite early on, and I'm going to play a couple clips here just to give you an idea of some of the interviews here as soon as the children went missing, and then we'll continue here with that. Okay, and this comes from KGET. You might have to turn up your volume a little bit.
The two little boys say they reported them missing last Monday, just before 6 p.m. But what happened before has the community worried.
They are going to be here in this area.
Trizelle and Jacqueline West are the adoptive parents of the missing boys. Trizelle says at around 5 p.m., the boys were playing on their back porch. He says Jacqueline was inside wrapping presents while he went out the back gate to gather wood for a fire.
I came to the house, I saw them there. One house. I came back out. I didn't see him there.
Trizelle says he and his wife searched inside the house and around the backyard. He then drove around the neighborhood calling their names and talking to neighbors, but saw nothing.
So then I came home and I told my wife, we need to call the cops. It's getting dark and I need help. We gotta get going.
California City Police and dozens of locals searched the area.
Okay. And then, so after that, just the next day on December 22nd, there was a police news conference, and police are saying that they do, in fact, suspect foul play. So they certainly have more information than we know. And here's where it gets a little bit more disturbing, really, is on December 23rd, the next day. A couple things happen. Biological mother, Ryan Dean, if you guys are wondering where the biological family is, she apparently does come from Bakersfield and does end up helping with the search. Now, she suspects that the foster parents, the adopted parents, are actually involved in this. So there's a couple different articles on that. If we go, and I'll show you here, right, a couple, let me pull that up here real quick here. So there's one right in here where she's talking about Let me see if I can find it here for you real quick here. Okay, so here's where police do suspect foul play, okay? Now, they didn't comment on whether they're alive or not, but here's where we're getting a little into it here, and I'll come back to the mother here in a minute. Police do a search warrant. They actually get a search warrant for the house. They end up digging up part of the backyard, and this is coming from a lot of different sources here. They collected bags of evidence, and there were forensics out there. Apparently, they were collecting DNA on items in the home, which is common when you have some suspicious missing children out there. They're going to collect DNA, but it's not a good sign. Not a good sign for this case. And then, of course, the mother. Going back to the mother, let me show you her interview here, so you guys know who she is.
The biological mother of the two boys came from Bakersfield on Wednesday to help with the search.
And I just had to be here because my babies are supposedly missing from this house, so I just need to be right here right now.
Neighbors say Bakersfield police and the FBI are involved in the investigation.
Okay, so you had a chance to see the biological mother. And Ryan Dean, this is part of the article I wanted to show you. She actually suspects that the adoptive parents are involved in their disappearance. She actually said, according to this article here, that they did something. I feel like they did something and they know something, she says. The West's four other children have reportedly been taken into protective custody. So that's another thing that's a little interesting. You've got police doing these searches. The children now are taken out of the home. They're in protective custody. You know, what do police know? What is going on? Apparently, the adoptive parents have been cooperative. Okay, so I'm not saying that they're suspects. It's just a little fishy, is what we know so far. And they've apparently been cooperative. They've been interviewed. Police are not saying that they are suspects. And then they've also, you know, willingly left the home, allowed police to search. So they've been very cooperative as far as we know. There's just some suspicious aspects to this here. And another thing that's suspicious about it is the community, for whatever reason, they believe that something's going on with these two as well, because, you know, they're from this article here, the family had to actually write a statement, because apparently there's been some, you know, some vandalism, people throwing rocks and breaking windows in the home. And apparently even vandals have been trying to break into the home. So the family released a statement, and I'll just highlight some of those points here. And I found this from findourboys2021.medium.com. But they had to release this statement here, and I'll go over what that is. Okay, so a couple things that the family pointed out here was, you know, of course, it's been a true nightmare for them. And that they're just trying to find their boys for a safe return. They go on to talk about how, you know, they're obviously in shock, they're worried, they're heartbroken over this, and then they talk about, you know, some of the other family that have been adopted, and then going through more, they talk about, you know, these theories. Apparently, there's some speculation and theories on why the family, you know, has been avoiding the press. So some people are suspicious of the two adoptive parents because they're not going out. They're not greeting people who are actively searching for the family, because you've got this community that's searching all over, and they're searching, and they're wondering, okay, why aren't the adoptive parents involved leading in these searches? Well, the adoptive family saying, you know, things like, you know, that they don't feel safe right now, that they've been told to stay in and avoid the press and those types of things. So I can understand that. But for whatever reason, you've got a group of the community who, you know, is, and you can see it right here, there's threats of physical violence, including death threats. There's, you know, they're being pelted, the home's being pelted with rocks, the window's broken. And then I mentioned the vandals being broke, you know, trying to break into the home. So a lot going on there. And again, just giving you the information. I don't know why that is. What, you know, maybe you do. If you do, leave some comments below. Let me know what your thoughts are on that. What you think about Trizelle and about Jacqueline. You know, I'm neutral here. I'm not going to say they're guilty or they're innocent. We just need more facts at this point, which I think law enforcement may have at this point, knowing that, you know, forensics, bags of evidence, digging up the backyard was just a huge red flag to me. You know, why are they digging up the backyard with their what do they have that makes them want to dig that up? I mean, they obviously have some evidence, especially with a search warrant, to be able to go and do that. FBI being involved, it's a pretty interesting case, and we're going to learn more. I have a feeling we're going to learn more soon. But let me know your thoughts. Let me know your opinions here on this case. Still missing to this day, you guys. This is my first video in 2021. I hope everyone's having a good 2021, but let's try to find these two children who are still missing. And if you do have any information, I do have that phone number. If you happen to be in that area, or anywhere in that area, you can call the California City Police at 760-373-8606. All right, this is Dev with Crime Hive, and we will see you next week in another video. Thanks.